subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chonsong. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 17th of November. Vehicular movement restricted, educational institutions shut indefinitely in Indian capital to tackle pollution. Pakistan government passes controversial electoral reforms despite opposition protest. And Sri Lanka shuts only oil refinery to manage forex crisis. And now for all the details. Amid the worsening situation of pollution in Indian capital, the Delhi government on Wednesday announced several measures including extension to work from home policy till November 21st, closure of educational institutions indefinitely, ban on construction activities and a curb on vehicular movement. Delhi's overall air quality index has remained in the very poor category for the past three consecutive days and is expected to worsen.
With Indian capital New Delhi and its neighbouring areas struggling to cope up with deteriorating air quality, the Delhi government on Wednesday announced several measures to tackle pollution after a high-level meeting to ensure the implementation of directions of the Commission for Air Quality Management. The measures include forming of a special task force of traffic police to monitor the traffic congestion and hiring of around 1,000 private CNG-run buses to increase public transport. Schools and other educational institutions will remain shut till further notice, while construction activities will remain banned till November 21st. This came after Indian Supreme Court on Wednesday rapped the government over its failure to mitigate pollution in the city.
Sarkari vibhagon mein work from home rahega. 21 tarikh tak extend kar diya gaya hai. Delhi mein स्कूल, कॉलेज, इंस्टीट्यूट्स, ट्रेनिंग सेंटर्स, लाइब्रेरी, ये सभी फर्दर ऑर्डर तक बंद।
The overall AQI air quality index on Wednesday stood at 379 on a scale of 500, indicating very poor conditions, according to forecasting body Safar. A toxic mix of pollutants wreathing New Delhi's air for the past four nights has fueled an alarming increase in the respiratory ailments, especially among children and the elderly, doctors say.
India on Tuesday slammed Pakistan at the United Nations for racking up the Kashmir issue and asserted it will continue to take firm and decisive action against cross-border terrorism emanating from Pakistan. Indian diplomat Kajol Bhatt blamed Pakistan's representative of misusing UN platforms and seeking in vain to divert the world's attention from the sad state of his country where terrorists enjoy a free pass.
India will continue to take firm and decisive action against cross-border terrorism emanating from Pakistan. Kajol Bhatt, counselor in India's permanent mission to the UN, said at the United Nations Security Council meet on Tuesday as she slammed Islamabad for raking up the Kashmir issue. Bhatt blamed the Pakistani representative Munir Akram of misusing UN platforms to propagate false and malicious propaganda and seeking in vain to divert the world's attention from the sad state of his country where terrorists enjoy a free pass. The Indian diplomat also called upon Pakistan to immediately vacate areas of Jammu and Kashmir under its illegal occupation, stating that they are integral and inalienable part of India.
This is a country which has been globally recognized as one openly supporting training, financing and arming terrorists as a matter of state policy. It holds the ignoble record of hosting the largest number of terrorists proscribed by the UN Security Council.
Meanwhile, India's Interior Ministry held a review meeting on Wednesday over the security situation in Jammu and Kashmir, which has been witnessing a spate in terror activities and civilian killings by Pakistan-based terror groups. Earlier this week, a Pakistani terrorist and his associate were killed in an encounter in Haidarpura area in Jammu and Kashmir. As many as 133 terrorists, including many top commanders, have been neutralized this year, Jammu and Kashmir police said recently.
In news from Pakistan, amid fervent protests by the opposition, the Pakistan government on Wednesday managed to pass amendments to the Elections Act 2017 in the joint session of the parliament, allowing the use of electronic voting machines and granting voting rights to overseas Pakistanis. As the session started in the afternoon, opposition leader in the National Assembly, Shehbaz Sharif, had termed electronic voting machines or EVMs as evil and vicious machines, and accused the government of not being sincere in creating a consensus on the electoral reforms despite initially delaying the session. Reports suggested the ruling party and its allies had total 221 voters, while the opposition had 219. The passing of the legislation prompted the opposition to tear copies of the agenda, chanting slogans and walk out of the session in protest.
हमने उसको चैलेंज किया, उसकी बात भी हमारी उन्होंने नहीं मानी, तो बिलाखिर जब हमने एहतजाज किया, मैंने खुद गया हूँ, मैं बिलावल भुट्टो साहब गए, मौलाना असद गए, उन्होंने नहीं माने, तो फिर हमने
हमने ऑपोजिशन किया।
मूविंग ऑन, amid an all-time high inflation, the cost of LPG gas cylinders has touched a new high in Gilgit-Baltistan. Locals have claimed it has made their lives difficult as it is an essential requirement to light a fire and keep themselves warm during winters. They have blamed the government has been apathetic to their plight and have demanded relief.
With the advent of winters, locals in Gilgit-Baltistan are reeling under the high price rise of liquefied petroleum gas or LPG cylinders amid an already all-time high inflation. Pakistan's Oil and Gas Regulatory Authority in early November increased the LPG price by rupees 13 per kilogram. According to reports, LPG prices are touching rupees 217 per kilogram, up 67% over last year. Locals have claimed that they are struggling to buy even basic domestic needs and said they're struggling to keep themselves warm in the chilly nights. With forest scarce and the government cracking down on illegal logging, locals have no option left but to buy the LPG gas to survive the harsh winter season.
एक तो हमारे पास जंगल नहीं है, अब बंदे की मजबूरी है, बच्चों को पालना है, सर्दी से बचाना है, बीमारियों से बचाना है, उनके लिए फिर हीटिंग तो करनी है, हीटिंग करने के लिए हम कहाँ जाए, जंगल तो हमारे पास है नहीं, हमने लाके एक सिलेंडर ही खरीदना है, अब सिलेंडर भी 3500 से 4000 तक हो तो फिर वो गरीब के पहुँच वो ये भी दूर है।
इस इलाके के हमारे जो खुदनूश है, इन चीज़ों में कमी लाई जाए और खुसूसन पेट्रोल में कमी लाई जाए ताकि यहाँ के गरीब लोग इस सर्दी का मुकाबला कर सकें और अपने बाल बच्चों को की कफालत बआसानी कर सके, उनके लिए लकड़ी खरीद सके, उनके लिए गर्म कपड़े खरीद सके।
लोकल्स इन गिलगित-बल्तिस्तान ब्लेम द पाकिस्तान गवर्नमेंट हैज रिपीटेडली टर्न्ड अ ब्लाइंड आई टू देयर प्रॉब्लम्स फेस्ड बाय द पीपल ऑफ द इलीगली ऑक्युपाइड रीजन। Years of continued neglect by Islamabad has made Gilgit-Baltistan one of the most backward regions under Pakistan's rule.
In news from Afghanistan, Afghanistan's acting Foreign Minister Amir Khan Muttaqi, in a letter to the United States Congress, has asked for the release of Afghanistan's central bank assets frozen by the US government. Afghanistan was plunged into crisis in August after Taliban fighters drove out a Western-backed Afghan government, prompting donors to hold back billions of dollars in assistance for the aid-dependent economy.
Afghanistan plunged into crisis in August after Taliban fighters drove out a Western-backed Afghan government. The victory saw the billions of dollars in foreign aid that had kept the economy afloat abruptly switched off, with more than $9 billion in central bank reserves frozen outside the country. Restrictions on the banking system put in place by international governments since the Taliban took over have deepened the pain for Afghans, prompting growing calls for the freeze on the reserves to be lifted. Afghanistan's acting Foreign Minister Amir Khan Muttaqi, in a letter to the US Congress on Wednesday, asked for the release of Afghanistan's central bank assets frozen by the US government. The letter says, "We are of the belief that freezing Afghan assets cannot resolve the problem at hand, neither is it the demand of the American people, hence your government must unfreeze our capital." The foreign ministry in the letter highlighted that if the Afghan assets remain frozen, problems in Afghanistan will increase given that winter is fast approaching. Taliban leaders have time and again called on the US to unfreeze Afghanistan's assets, saying that the money is for the Afghan people. Since returning to power, the Taliban say they have moved as quickly as possible on opening up their government and guaranteeing rights to women, and that they do not represent a threat to any other country.
Moving on to news from Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka has temporarily shut down its only oil refinery following the non-availability of crude oil supplies due to the ongoing severe foreign exchange crisis in the country. Sri Lanka's Energy Minister Udaya Gamapila has said that fuel imports would resume once the government is able to raise sufficient dollars, but did not give details of a timeline.
Sri Lanka has temporarily shut its only oil refinery as part of efforts to manage dwindling foreign exchange reserves, the Energy Minister Udaya Gamapila said on Tuesday, triggering long queues at petrol stations. The 51-year-old Sapugaskanda oil refinery, which has a capacity of 50,000 barrels per day, was closed on Monday, Gamapila said at the weekly cabinet briefing. He added that fuel imports would resume once the government was able to raise sufficient dollars, but did not give details of a timeline.
Petrol nani? Hey, petrol is a poly minde one mana garda. Agar sapai api dukai, itchera jana bula.
Faced with rising inflation and dwindling reserves, the government is discussing a bailout for its economy. Sri Lanka is also attempting to negotiate a $500 million credit line with India to buy fuel and boost reserves, which dropped to $2.27 billion at the end of October. During the first 9 months of 2021, Sri Lanka spent $692 million on fuel imports, its highest import expenditure.
As I warned on 29th September at a media briefing, we have decided to temporarily close down the Sapugaskanda oil refinery because of the shortage in the foreign currency in the country. So we have to maximally utilize the limited foreign currency reserves for importation of the essential goods.
President Gotabaya Rajapaksa in August declared a food emergency to contain soaring prices and tackle shortages of staples as the foreign exchange crisis deepened. Consumers have been struggling with shortages of multiple essential items over the last few weeks. A decision by the government to ban chemical fertilizer imports, combined with bad weather, has also driven up vegetable and fruit prices, with food inflation hitting 12.8% in October.
The meadows of Pampore town in India's Jammu and Kashmir are attracting crowds of tourists who flock to witness the picturesque view of colorful flowers in bloom with the start of the saffron harvesting season. Saffron is one of the world's most expensive spices, and Pampore is famed for its saffron production. Blooming saffron flowers in Pampore town of India's northern Jammu and Kashmir territory are attracting tourists from different parts of the country. Pampore area, which is famed for its saffron production, is an attractive destination for tourists who flock to the place during the bloom period, when the fields look picturesque due to the maroon, yellow and purple hues of the saffron flowers. Delighted visitors clicked pictures and gained information about the flower as they stopped their vehicles at highway to enjoy the beauty of the saffron fields.
जी ये बहुत ही बढ़िया है, बहुत ही खूबसूरत लग रहा है और ये नवंबर महीना सैफरन का स्पेशली नवंबर महीना है, अक्टूबर नवंबर के बीच में ये इसका क्रॉप होता है तो हम एग्जैक्टली वही टाइम पे आए हैं तो वी आर वेरी फॉर्चुनेट इनफ टू सी दिस सैफरन ब्लूमिंग इन द फील्ड्स।
इस साल हमने देखा है कि जो अभी जो ये सैफरन लैंड है काफ़ी ब्लूम पे है और इस साल काफ़ी अच्छी पैदावार निकल रही है और जो भी कश्मीर टूरिस्ट आ रहे हैं तो वो इन सैफरन लैंड्स में आना बहुत पसंद करते हैं, उनको अच्छा लगता है यहाँ पे वीडियोग्राफी करना, फोटोग्राफी करना।
सैफरन इज वन ऑफ द वर्ल्ड्स मोस्ट एक्सपेंसिव स्पाइसेस।
Kashmir's cool climate and rich soil with excellent drainage and organic content make the location an ideal thriving ground for this spice. But any vagaries of the weather can spoil the entire crops. Iran is the leading producer of saffron globally, followed by India.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter at @asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.